start a conversation.
Fun. Love is a profoundly tender, passionate affection for another person, or feeling of warm personal attachment or deep affection is for a parent, child, or friend. You knew this was coming. This is the most influential emotion that we could ever envision. The positive and negative effects from it are just about limitless. Did you know that a simple hug can reduce cholesterol, make stress plummet to none at all, and make a person less vulnerable to sickness for an entire day? One hug. Kissing stabilizes the cardiovascular activity. It decreases high blood pressure, it lowers cholesterol, it cleans your teeth, and it burns 12 calories per 5-second episode. 3 passionate kisses a day will make you lose a pound because you're stimulating over 30 muscles in your face. And I didn't look up French kissing. Personally, I have witnessed love in my own life do such amazing things that words cannot do justice. I was going down a dark path around my junior year of high school. I really didn't care about anything. My brother was off at college. My parents were getting divorced. They were the whole, I hate you, I hate you. And then they're like, oh, Nathan's worth money. I love you. And it was really fun like that. I stopped caring about school around 7th or 8th grade, so I was kind of a mess. No one knew because I covered it up with humor. And one day, an angel from a few lockers down took my facade away. So many years of being angry, hateful, numb, and this girl was just like, ha, I'm taking your mask off. Love. She made all that hurt go away. I felt something I never felt before. Purpose, a goal, love. Think about that. By her simply being herself, she like purified my soul. And an example of purification is, I was a dummy. I never wore gloves in the winter, and in Menasha it gets to negative 40 every winter. So I killed all the nerves in my hands. I can't feel anything. And one day, I grabbed her hand because I was being a dork, and she grabbed it back, and I almost cried. I was like, even if this does work out, I'm never gonna feel her hands ever. But lo and behold, a few moments later, I was like, whoa. The first thing I felt in about 4 years with my hands was her soft, warm caress and velvet skin. It was breathtaking. It did come with a catch though. It wore off in about 30 minutes and they were back to this fun stuff. And they did have a nice long-term effect from junior to senior year and even till today. I know when I'm holding something now, which really helps when I'm putting stuff on tables and stuff. So drop it. I did that a lot. Inspiration is something love is well known for. Again, examples from my experience will aid understanding this. I wrote poems, I got flowers, chocolates, gifts, roses. I thought of everything I could to do to make her life perfect, and it was with no effort at all. And I really don't know about that, but maybe I was just enjoying doing all this stuff so much that it didn't seem like I was putting any effort forward. By far my most impressive act in my mind of inspiration was I had to play piano for the play, so I went out, bought a keyboard, and learned a song so I could play it for her because I knew she was coming to the play. And I learned the song in 2 days by ear, no previous piano experience. And I can't do that anymore, but love gave me the ability to play the piano. Of course, with every great thing, there is at least one negative. Love really doesn't have a negative. How many of you think I'm a genuinely happy person? Well, if you believe that, you're wrong. I have been downright miserable for the last 2 years. Still in the context that love has power, let's delve into how badly it can hurt someone. A little after December 2007, all the way until college, I got 3 hours of sleep a night. I was so stressed out. Love for her wouldn't let me sleep. First 2 weeks I was here, I didn't sleep at all, and currently I sleep little, if any. Monday being a prime example of not sleeping at all. My body grew crippled and fatigued, occasionally coughing up blood. There were random chest pains that, to be modest, were very painful. And I looked it up clinically. That could be heart attacks, but that's just symptoms. I don't know. It runs in my family, though. Often, simple tasks became difficult. Became stressed to breathe, and sometimes even when my heart beat, it would feel like it was pumping oil through my body. It really just hurt. Inside my head is a torrent of screaming and agony. My mind never shuts up about her, which is probably why I'm awake all the time. The average human can sustain about a month of this level of stress before dying. I've learned this in health class, psychology, from doctors. Well, I'm going on 2 years, so take that, statistics. How can this be? By every statistical standpoint, I should be dead 100 times over. The only logical explanation I have is that love is keeping me alive. Does it seem odd that no one knows how I'm really feeling or how hurt I am? Yet again, love comes into the picture. I put on this mask every single day, and I don't do it for me. I do it because I love everything and everyone in this world, save for one person. And for the record, the mask is who I want to be, who I was, and who I probably never will really be again. Some more food for thought. If I were allowed to go back in time, I could stop all this pain. I could look in the mirror and not cringe every day and go, "Ugh, I really don't like you." If I could just take all this pain away, I would not go back and stop meeting her for that maybe month I thought she could possibly care about someone like me. And I honestly believe if she decided that I was the best thing that ever happened to her tomorrow, she could probably, her love could probably fix everything that is wrong with me. Love is our most powerful emotion. It can move mountains, shape the world, and even destroy someone's. It inspires the uninspired, makes unhealthy well again, and can be the final thread holding a life together.